Hello, welcome back to Average Gamer Plays Factorio. Now, I have designed my 5k chemical science build. So now it's time to build it. So whereabouts in the base am I? Oh, I'm near the solar panel. All right, okay. I've been putting down a few more solar panels in the meantime. I now have nearly 300,000. So that is going rather well. While we are building this, so we've got 4,000 accumulators. We've only got 175 solar panels, so we'll let those build up a little bit. Let those build up a little bit before putting down some more. So let's wander over to where we were going to build the chemical science, which is over there. Let's get that the right way around. I'll wander over there like that. I'm going to avoid all of the lakes. I will just about avoid all the lakes. Now, do I still have a building train? I do still have a building train set up over there. So let's actually just go over there and take out this building train and rebuild it over there for the chemical science. Need me power poles. Okay, so that is now going to be building train 4 5k chem. Now power up. So we will need let's just sort of pick up as much of this stuff as I can by hand. Now then, we need 4 trains coming in. Now, the way that I've already done it before is that, because I've worked out that these lines across here are not the same length. So, we need 4 in from the right. And we're only going to have one of these stations, so we'll have it that way round. Okay. Okay. So we've picked up everything that we can from over there. We've now cleared out a lot of space in our inventory because... let's just give him back... Give the Spidertron back some robots. Right, in fact, let's wander back over. Now that the Spidertron's got some robots, let's just see how much more of this stuff we can get built. So that's cool. I had everything on me to build all of that. Now then. Chemical Science 5K. We're going to have one of those, and everything's going to come in from the left. The highest input is going to be just about there where the Spidertron is. Actually, yes, it's about there. So we can line that up with the station's output there, and we'll just sort of build it, for the sake of argument, right in the middle there. And that's some more, that's mining productivity 29 done. Which I'm very impressed with. So let's just use up all of the items that we actually had on us at the time. Right. Let's get some roboports in place. So that we can then get the bots to come along and finish all this. We'll need one there, one there. Another one there. Now obviously these aren't going to be powered yet, so let's big electric bulb. It is. Little electric pole, or medium one. Medium one. That's actually powered from there. So that should all have power there. Let's put some construction bots in there. Let's then say we want, we don't need so many rails or anything like that. We need some belts, so we'll have 200 of those. I think we need some undergrounds. I think we need some splitters. We need some of those. I don't think I'm using any of those, but we'll have 50 of those anyway. I don't think I'm using any of those. We'll need lots of assembly machines. We'll need some speed modules. We'll need some productivity modules. We'll need some substations. We'll have another 10 RoboPorts. We'll still need lots more beacons. We'll have, I think it's 60 or something, or 70 on the train. Let's have some more of those stations. I think I've got plenty of those on me at the for the time being. Don't need any of those yet. I think we can always add to those later on. I occasionally see something flashing. Okay. Right, so that is called Building Train for 5k Chem. So we'll go to our Trains menu. Building Train Load. Take that one out. Five seconds of activity. I'm not even sure whether that train, that station still exists, but we'll leave that there. Now this train should now come forwards and backwards a little bit quicker because it's being powered off nuclear fuel, I believe. Yes, it is. Right, so it might take a little while for these bots because they're not it's not a straight line, so they're going to have to sort of go up to there and then they come back to recharge, but that's fine. They will, you know, they'll get everything built eventually. So they are now happily sort of doing their thing, which they keep on doing. So we'll leave those to get on with it. I will need to make sure that these other stations are set up to request the items and that the outputs from these stations are all wired in properly. So we'll have this first station. Over there is going to request iron plates. I think it was minus 115,200 it had there. Because, well, hang on a minute, let's get my calculator out again. Iron plate stacks to 100. Four trains per wagon times eight wagons. It's 153,600. And this is going to be from network ID 1, and we're requesting 32,000 at a time. The next station is, so that's iron plate. We need steel bar, red circuits, and sulfur. So for the sake of argument, we'll do red circuits next. And again, that they stacked 200 times 48 slots in a wagon times 4 wagons times 8, 307,200. And they will request 64,000 at a time, and it is network ID 1. Sulfur. Think stacks to 50, so 50 times 48 times 4 times 8 is 76,800. And I think that is 50 times 40 times 8 is $16,000 on a train. And then the last one is going to be steel bar, and I think they stack to 100 as well. So 100 times 48 times 4 times 8 is 153,600. And I think that is going to be 32,000 on a train. So this one is going to be, so we've got 4 balanced coming out. Now we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Right. So, do we just want to have? I've had this before with the trains unloading unevenly. Yes, I shall redesign this one. I've done this before, haven't I? I've sort of taken off. I've put away all my construction bots, so I don't have any. They're all in the system. Spidertron still has some construction bots though. So this is 8 coming off the train there, so I need an 8 to 7 balancer. One, two, three, four. Now I might need to still run get rid of that line there. I don't think I need that. So I want to make sure that when I've got things like, so this next train along is for the red circuits. So I've basically got, actually, we only need... Right, hang on a minute, let's have a rethink of this. We only need two lines of red circuits, so I can do these as being... I can tidy these up as well a little bit, I think. I can basically have 4-1 over there, which I think is just a straightforward simple one like that. That can then just come out like that. So that's for red circuits, so that's going to go up to there. Sulfur is going to be something very, very similar. So that one there is sulfur. The third train along, so I can get rid of all of that, all of that, all of that. So again, very similar. I'm going to have four to one. One balancer over there. In fact, I might just move it up a little bit. I don't know. Let me just borrow 50 of his construction bots. That coming along there next to it. So that is then sulfur going in there. That needs to come along and up there a little bit, might be a little bit. A little bit funky, but that is sulfur going along and up there as well. And then we just need two lines of steel plate coming in at the bottom. So again, we can do something very, very similar. A 4-to-1 balancer of each side of the train. Going. go down to that. So how are we doing now on the rest of this? Got lots of undergrounds used up there. Right, I don't have any more roboports. Does the Spidertron have any roboports? Doesn't look like it. And pick those up and turn them into landfill. Turn them into landfill, come on. Oops, I can turn them into landfill. Still got are we just waiting for a train to come back, or is everything gone idle for a minute? That is still waiting. Okay, so right, we do still have some roboports. So that's waiting. Yeah, it's waiting for pretty much everything, isn't it? That one has power from there. Don't have any substations on me, but I do have the big electric poles. Wait for that one to come online, which it does there. That one can go over there and that will be powered. That one there isn't connected to anything, so we'll have to put another one so that one there has got power. Sure that that does have power. So the question is, why? Oh, the train. I think the train has just been again. But it's on its way back still. So the train is still working. That's good going. So we're still missing, belts, beacons, speed modules. There's a section up there that's not covered because that is not powered. Big electric pole. That has power. That now has power. So everything there is connected. That's good. So this is going to be an LTN load. I'll do it on the same side. So 1, 2, 3, 4. We'll have that. We'll have it up there in a little bit. Building train still on its way back. So we've got rails in. Let's come here and pick up the chemical science. So that station is going to be a provider station, and I think it's going to be 32,000. That's fine. That we need to rename. Chemical science pickup. And that's going to be a line like that. So let's just pick up some rails off the thing there. And I'll give you that. A few little bits and pieces left over. These speed modules. So they need to. Yeah, when the train next comes in. Right, so we'll start turning off. We don't need any more rails. We don't need any more of those, four of those. While that is there, let's just leave that in manual mode for a minute. We can now start taking some of this stuff up and then putting this back. Let's pick up all of those. We can put the spare items here back onto the train and they can take them straight away now back to the base. And take those back, take that. So we still need, all right, so we still need 45, which I've got on me here, speed modules. See on the little mini map all the flashing lights that are now not flashing. And that's it, that build is now done. So we can be nice and neat and tidy and put a whole bunch of stuff into the trash wagon on the train. Don't need so many of those. I don't think I need so many logistics robots. I don't need any more of those on me. What's the Spider-Tron got that we can get rid of? Not a great deal. I don't think we need to have quite so many trains and wagons on him now, because I think I've built a lot of those that I need. He doesn't need some of those. So that I don't need so many of those. I can put back all the stuff there for the actual building train build itself. Put those back onto there. Don't think I need I'm only requesting 50 prod modules, so I can put the rest back onto there. Okay, so you can go back to building train load. You can come up. So I need to now just make sure, don't need to take that radar away. Right, so let's just link this in to power on the other side. Doesn't really matter which side it took power from though, but oh, that's interesting, a couple of little bits and pieces still going down there. Right. Um, So there's still a So that still did need the power, that's fine. That has all got power. That's all got power. I'll possibly take up some of these substations from here as I did with some of the other builds, but I'm not bothered about that for the time being. So this is a power pole there that can come out. So we've got power. Oh yes, and I just need to make sure that this power across here is still complete. Let's just come out of there so I can see what I'm doing. That is now completely powered. That has got a line going across to there and a single line going across to there and a single line coming up here. But it works. Might still put a bit of redundancy into there. I don't know. Yeah. Let me take out that other rogue power pole because that's going to annoy me every single time I look at the map. Now, I will wait until the next episode to turn this on, although I know for a fact it works, and I also know that it's going to start requesting a whole bunch of stuff from everything else. Everything else is going to leap into action. However, it might be an idea to sort of turn the factory on in stages. In fact, shall I do it now? That's interesting. Nothing's happening. Oh yes, we have some requests. And we have a train on the go. Oh, that's going to go over to there to pick up some steel, I think. Which should then cause, yes, there's four trains coming over here to pick up steel. Those will eventually cause more trains to come over and start delivering the iron ore.